Now here at home, marathon veterans and enthusiasts can test themselves in the fifth edition of the Philippine Marine Corps Marathon, dubbed the toughest road race in the country. It is an annual fundraising event where participants can race with members of the military's elite force while also supporting projects to help ill and battle-scarred servicemen and their dependents. And here with us in the studio to discuss this event is the head of the organizing committee, Ana Marie Pareño, and Captain Felix Serapio of the Philippine Marines Public Office. Good day to you, Ms. Ana and Captain Serapio. Maraming salamat po for joining us here on ANC Game Time. So, Ma'am Ana, I just want to ask first, so how did this all come about?
It started in 2015 when it was just an idea. And then it came out na parang we wanted to do more to support the Corps, to do something for the Marines other than being there. We wanted to do something for the wounded Marines and for the scholars of the Marines.
And it's also very special for your group because organized by the Corps and Marine Corps Officers Spouses Association.
Yes.
Okay. So how special is this, of course, para po matulungan, of course, our Marines, Philippine Marines?
Siyempre, as a wife, as a Marine wife, we wanted to do more for the Marines. Nakikita kasi namin na years back, hindi pa doblado ang sweldo ng mga marino, ng mga sundalo. So, financially, we need to do more something for the Corps. So, we came up with this idea, the Marine Corps Marathon, na ginaya lang namin sa US. So, we adopt it here in the Philippines, and then now, we're already on our fifth year.
Captain Serapio, how big of a deal is this, of course, for a big boost for the Marine program?
Yes, sir. It is very important to us. It is very beneficial to us. For we all know the Marines are deployed in combat-prone areas. So a lot of our Marines, enlisted personnel and officers alike, they incur casualties. Some of them lose their limbs. Some of them even lose their part of their bodies, their eyes. So the Marine Corps Spouses Association will help them financially through the funds generated from these kinds of events.
I know it has grown over the years. Since the first year, you only had 1,000 and then increased to 3,000, looking to 5,000 this year. But also besides the program, of course, for financial assistance. Sir, how about health and wellness, lifestyle in promoting, of course, the program to the ones that will actually, who are actually joining?
Yes, sir. Since the Marine Corps is as branded as one of the toughest forces in the Philippines, we are promoting our physical fitness. So it is one of the concepts why the program has come about.
I understand there are other numerous types of runs, yeah. Ana. So can you discuss them, please?
We have actually four distances. We have 5K, 10K, 25K, and 42K. It's a foot race that will bring you from the training ground of the Marine Corps that is in Marine Base Gregorio Lim, Ternate, Cavite, going through Cabiang Tunnel up to Pico del Oro, then go back for a beachfront finish. I just want to also add that we have a cannon start instead of a gun start.
Okay.
Cannon start of a 105 howitzer.
All right, so more of a
for grand, every distance, yeah.
Yes, for more of a grand, more or less start, and at the same time to celebrate, of course, each milestone.
Yes.
Of the run. But then I want to discuss more on the advocacy, more from supporting the Marines. There's also a special advocacy in tied with this, Captain.
Yes, sir. As I've said a while ago, the Marines incurred a lot of casualties, especially in the recent conducts of atrocities in the country, like for example the Marawi siege. So more or less around the Marines alone incurred more or less around 500 casualties already. Some of my men lost their limbs, some of my men lost their eyes, and 35 of us gave the ultimate sacrifice. So the PM COSAI saw, and the Marine Corps organization saw, that the troops needed some type of financial support, though the government gives them everything. But they saw that there are certain instances that they could insert and give more to boost their morale and then continue their service with the Marine Corps. So there are programs except and out of the financial support that were given to them. There are programs supported by the PM COSAI, one of which is they're supporting the students of our Marines. And then there are starting programs on which when our Marines, because of the trauma and because of they feel that they've given everything and they see to it that they had enough. So there are programs that they could choose if they would want to opt, if they opt to be out of the service already. There are programs like we do have example, we're training them to become bakers. So
something out of it, just to, you know, create a hobby.
Yes.
And enhance the mental awareness.
That's the main problem. The spirit is fighting, the body is fighting, but then when there's a mental breakdown, your Marines, all hell will break loose.
Of course.
Yes, sir.
Besides, of course, addressing mental health issues, you spoke of programs and continuing development. Also for the Marine dependents, you mentioned it earlier, Captain Serapio. Anna, can you discuss more on, of course, the help for the Marine dependents?
We also have educational financial assistance extended to the Marine dependents. That's the sons or daughters of our Marine, EP Marines, Enlisted Personnel Marines. We have these guidelines of the criteria on how they can avail of the scholarship.
Okay, so this will be on October 27th.
Yes.
All right,
yes.
So kindly, Captain Serapio, kindly invite our viewers, or how can they be part if they want to, you know, participate and support the Marines?
Yes, I'm inviting everybody. I'm inviting enthusiasts to support. Even though you're not runners, enthusiasts who would want to support your Marine Corps, please join us. You may either inquire online through our Facebook fan page. That would be the Philippine Marine Corps Marathon 2019 fan page. And you can also inquire to Philippine Marine Corps fan page.
Okay, so there you have it, Captain Felix Serapio and Anna Marie Pareño. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming
and mabuhay ang mga Marino. Thank you so much for joining us here on ANC Game Time.
Thank you.